Namaskaram to all and welcome to the 8th session of the Trimurti Shakti Vandana series. Yesterday we started with the Devi compositions of Dikshitar and we saw the Kriti Shri Kantimatin of Tirunelveli composed by Dikshitar. Today at the outset let me wish all of you a happy Saraswati Puja. On this occasion specifically we shall be taking up one of the Kritis of Dikshitar on Goddess Saraswati. This is the Kriti Veena Pustaka Dharini in Raga Vegavahini. The Raga Vegavahini can be considered as a janyam of the Melakarta, 16th Melakarta Chakravaham in the Tyagaraja Parampara and Toya Vegavahini in the Dikshitar Parampara. Now this term itself is very beautiful. Vega Vahini. I was just thinking, the term itself means what? Vegam means speed. Vahini means flowing. The one that is flowing with speed. That is, so it is basically indicating a river. How did Dikshitar choose this for a Kriti on Saraswati? Possibly he is indicating also to the river Saraswati of the Vedic civilization. When Saraswati was one of the major rivers, the Saraswati civilization is something that many scholars are doing research on. It became lupta. It dried away. It became antardhana over many centuries. But it was one of the major rivers. We'll find more references to river Saraswati than to the Ganga Yamuna rivers which we know today in the Vedas. So probably there is an indication, there is a correlation between Saraswati and a river, because the river as Saraswati itself existed in our Vedic literature, especially in the Rig Veda, and was one of the most celebrated rivers. But even if you come to the Purana Kala and the time today, where we know Saraswati as Goddess Saraswati, the Goddess of Learning, how is the connection of this Goddess of Learning with a river? Here we can relate this to a story of Lord Varadaraja Perumal of Kanchipuram. So the story of that goes that Brahma, once in a debate, took the side of Lakshmi, his mother. Lakshmi is Brahma's mother. So on a debate of who is greater, Saraswati or Lakshmi, he took the side of Lakshmi, his mother, rather than his wife Saraswati. So this angered Saraswati and she left Brahma and came to Bhuloka and started flowing in Bhuloka as a river. While coming from Brahmaloka, Saraswati also took the Srishti Danda along with her and came to Bhuloka. So without the Srishti Danda, Brahma could not create, could not resume his activity of creation. So to get back the Srishti Danda, he started penance at Satyavrata Kshetra, which can be identified as the modern day Kanchipuram. Hasti Shaila, that place where the temple of Varadaraja Perumal is right now. Attigiri. At that place was called as Satyavrata Kshetram. You find many records where Kanchipuram is mentioned as Satyavrata Kshetra, because whatever vrata or penance you do, tapas you do in that kshetra becomes satyam, becomes fruitful. That is why it came to be called Satyavrata Kshetram. In fact, it becomes thousandfold. The phala becomes thousandfold. So Brahma came and did a yaga in this place to get back the Srishti Danda. But even for doing the yaga, you need Yajamana Patni. But Brahma did not take Saraswati as the Yajamana Patni. Many Puranas state differently. Somewhere they say that he took Savitri or Gayatri as the Patni and did the Yajna. So this angered Saraswati. So she wanted to obstruct the Yajna of Brahma. So she did many things like removing the light from the place, sending hordes of elephants and all these things. So from all these things, Lord Vishnu protects Brahma and the sacrifice in various forms. And that is why you find various Vishnu temples signifying each of these forms. We'll not get into those details right now due to the paucity of time. At the end, she comes as river, because she's already in the form of a river, to completely wash away the entire Yajnashala. And that is where the Lord Vishnu, he sleeps as Yathoktakari Perumal. Today you find the temple of Yathoktakari Perumal, Sonnavannam Seitha Perumal. So he sleeps across the river, and so Saraswati is not able to overcome Vishnu and Flo, so she retreats back. So she came with that Vega to wash away the Yajnashala. So this is the relationship we can draw between Saraswati and the river concept. And she came as Vega Vahini with full speed to wash off the Yajnashala. So this is what I could relate between Saraswati as the deity, the goddess of learning, and the river. And that is how the all the relationship comes of this Vega Vahini. So all these ideas are very beautifully, they come to our mind the moment Dikshitar starts, composes a Kriti itself in a raga called Vega Vahini. Now let's look at this Kriti. It says, Veena Pustaka Dharinim Ashraye, Vega Vahinim Vanim Ashraye. So the goddess who has got Veena, Pustaka Dharini, she has got the Veena and she has got the Pustaka in her hands. Vega Vahini, that river that flowed to wash away the Yajnashala, Vanim, who is speech, who is the goddess of speech, Ashraye, I take refuge in her. Enanka Yuta Jatajuta Makutam Tam. Enanka Yuta. She has got the digit, the moon digit on her, the crescent moon on her forehead. This very beautiful form of Saraswati, especially you can see in the form of Sharada. Especially you see the Sringeri Sharada Vigraham. You'll find these aspects perfectly reflected in the Sharada Vigraham. The Pustaka Akshamala, then you will find the Enanka Yuta. The Veena, of course, is not present in the Vigraham, but if you see the different alankarams that are done to the Sharadambika, especially during the Navaratri season, you'll find also the Veena being given as one of the alankarams. And definitely, Saraswati is definitely associated with Veena. So, Enanka Yuta, Jata Juta Makutam. He has got Jata Juta. Because there is also one Puranic story that says that Saraswati is the sister of Rudra, of Shiva. So Shiva also has Jatajuta and Saraswati also has Jatajuta. Jatajuta Makutam. So that Jatajuta forms a crown, and in that crown there is a crescent moon. Ekagra Chitta Nidhyatam Vidhikantam. The one who is worshipped by Ekagra Chitta Nidhyatam. Vidhikanta. She is the one who provides Ekagra Chittam, and also the people who are focused and single-minded and meditating, Nidhyatam, who is the one who is meditated upon by the Ekagra Chittas, one whose mind is completely focused, all those jnanis, all those rishis and munis are meditating on her, Nidhyatam, Vidhikanta, the one who is the consort of Vidhi or Brahma. Because he rides the Vidhi or destiny for us, he is called as Vidhi. Vidhikanta. The Charanam. Paradi Akhila Shabda Swarupa Avakasham. She is the form of four kinds of speech. Paradi Akhila Shabda Swarupa. The entire Shabda Swarupa, the entire world of Shabda or sound is in the form of four stages. Para Paschanti Madhyama Vaikari. These are the four stages of speech or sound. Vaikari is the sound that is uttered, that you hear, the audible sound. Madhyama is the sound that is before the, it gets translated into speech. That is thought. All these thoughts that get translated into verbal form. So the thought form that becomes Madhyama. Paschanti is even before the thought, all the basic seed of the thought from where it comes, Paschanti. Para is the silence, the deep silence that is there in your Atma Swarupa. That is Para, the Para Vak. All the great jnanis and self-realized souls are in the Para state. They are in the Para Vak. They communicate through the Para Vak. Maunam. Dakshinamurti communicated through Maunam. That is the Para Vak, the highest form of speech. So Para Paschanti Madhyama Vaikari. So Paradi Akhila Shabda Swarupa Avakasha, who is the form of this entire universe of Shabda. Paurnami Chandrika Davala Sankasham, whose luster, whose shining is as white and shining as Paurnami Chandrika Davala, that whiteness compared to the Purnami Chandrika, the Purnami, the full moon, that light, that luster, the jyotsna of that full moon. Her luster is that, is compared to that. Harara Vindam, who is holding a lotus in her hand. Kalyana Dam, one who does good, auspiciousness. Mangala Bhasham, who is the very form of language. Kanaka Champaka Dama Bhusha Vishesham, who is adorned with golden. Kanaka Champaka, Champaka flowers, you know, but golden Champaka flowers. She is adorned with those golden Champaka flowers, garland of those golden Champaka flowers. Nirantaram Bhakta Jihvagra Vasam, who always resides at the end, the tip of the tongue of the Bhaktas. That means one who has the Kataksham of Vani or Saraswati, whatever he says comes true. Whatever she, because she resides here. So whatever he says happens. Nikhila Prapancha Sankocha Vikasam. She is responsible for the development as well as the annihilation of the entire universe, because the entire universe comes into being and goes back because of speech, because of sound. That is how the entire world gets created, through nada, through shabda. Naradhamanana vilokya shoka paham. What the shoka or the distress or the depression that we get by seeing adhama, the lowly people in the world, in the universe, who have no character, who are extremely lowly and very vile nature and characters and behaviors. Seeing all those people, you become depressed and you start behaving differently, away from dharma. So having seen all of them, the shoka that you get, she removes all that shoka, apaham. So whatever shoka you get because of seeing all these worldly and mundane people engrossed in adharma, all that is removed by her grace. Nara Harihara Guruguha Pujita Vigraha. She is adorned, she is worshipped not only by the Devas, she is worshipped by the Naras, definitely by all the men, the mortals. Harihara. Hari also worships, Hara also worships, Guruguha. Muruga and Muthuswami Dikshitar is referring to himself, Pujita Vigraham, the Vigraham that I am worshipping and adorning. It's a beautiful Kriti, and especially it's one of the jewels of the Brindama Bani, especially in the school of Brindama, and especially Brindama, her rendering of this Kriti. And my teacher has definitely learnt it from Brindama, and Aruna, who is also a student of Srimati Alamelumani. So that Bani or that school is very well reflected. The stamp of that school is very well reflected in this Kriti. And it's one of the jewels of that school, because it needs to be rendered with that kind of saukhyam in it, without going too fast, rendering with that kind of a saukhyam. So let's now listen to this Kriti, Veena Pustaka Dharini, Indraga Vega Vahini, by Vidushi Srimati Aruna Ranganathan. Veena Pustaka Dharini Mashaya Veena Pustaka Dharini Mashaya Veena Yeah. What a beautiful Kriti, and what a way to picturize. As you sing the Kriti, you can picturize the goddess Sharada in front of you. And, you know, all those descriptions matching, and the way Dikshitar, you know, glorifies the Divine Mother as the goddess of learning is simply beyond words. So I hope all of you enjoyed this and a very happy Saraswati Puja. We shall continue the session tomorrow with another Kriti. Until then, Namaskaram.